I am Mr. Gill.
I'm Patricia.
And I'm Embryo Designs.
And welcome to Sunday Video Fun Tim, which is our semi-traditional, regular... irregular.
Yeah.
YouTube talking time about Lego stuff, which we do on Sundays.
That's the definition.
Yes. Yeah. And it's a video, and we enjoy it, so it's fun.
Yeah,
and it happens at a certain time, so it's a tip. So it's something to do, a fun tip.
Yeah,
that's how it works. Today we're here to talk about Batman.
Yeah.
Or to be more specific, the Lego Batman Lego movie or the Lego Batman movie?
The Lego Batman movie.
The Lego Batman movie, which is a
spin-off of the Lego movie.
It's a spin-off of the Lego movie.
Yeah, starring Batman.
A spin-off of Batman?
It's a parody of Batman.
It's a parody of Batman. Okay, excellent. Which is coming out in about a couple of weeks worldwide, yep. I think, February 8th or
10th.
10th here in Europe. I just asked it before we started, and I just forgot as soon as we did it. So coming out in a couple of weeks, it's of course for Lego, this is a huge thing.
Yeah.
And for Lego collectors, this is a huge thing. There are the minifigures, which we're going to talk about today, and then I believe it's 24 sets?
A lot of them.
Yeah. I think maybe it's like 20 actual sets, and then as far I've seen like at least 10.
If you count every like poly bag, minifigure pack,
weird ass thing,
yeah. Everything, then it's almost like 20 to 25 sets or something like that.
Yeah. So there's a lot of stuff coming out, and Lego's been amping this for a while, and it's cool.
Yeah.
I mean, you know me, figures I'm not a big fan of, but the Batman in the Lego movie was hilarious.
Yeah.
I definitely will see this movie. I think it's going to be funny. I think they've got a very good, their way of telling the story, I know is going to be good. And I know people are going to like it. It's a kind of irreverent humor, you know, thing, which is going to be cool.
Yeah, and the director who's working on this has worked on, like, Robot Chicken, Family Guy, and a lot of humor-based stuff, which also parodies on DC superheroes, so they know what they are doing. So
it's going to be really good, which is awesome. So we thought we would just do a quick rundown of the 20 figures, which came out, I think, a couple of weeks back, maybe 4 or 5 weeks back in the US. But so in Europe, they've just kind of been hitting this week, kind of, for like other retailers. Lego's had them for a little while, but I got them just this week, and so they've been on the shelves for a little bit. Straight up, who do you think is the most popular? There's 20.
Most popular, any of the Batman figures.
Yeah, you'd be right.
Yeah,
we'll get to it, definitely. There's one, and I'm quite surprised by which one is the most popular.
Oh,
sold out already. I think I don't have any more left.
Interesting.
Quite interesting. So we're going to start from one. We're going to hopefully put a little picture at the bottom of the screen so you can see it. You could pause it if you like and zoom in.
Here-ish.
And then at the end, we will put up just maybe a screenshot of all 20 figures so that, again, you could pause it and zoom in and look at it and check it out, you know, if you want to. And, of course, there's loads of other websites that you can look at to find out the figures and all that kind of jazz. Number one
is... Lobster Loving Batman.
Lobster Loving Batman, is that his name?
Yeah.
That's his official name, Lobster Loving Batman. I think I just called him Lobster Batman.
Yeah.
This is hard, it's been hard to come up with funny names.
Yeah, and this is one of my favorites, because he has a really cool robe.
Because you can see his chest.
Not really that recent, but I haven't really thought about seeing Batman in robe. Usually just his bat suit, so I think that's kind of funny.
Do you often think about Batman in his bat suit?
Let's move on.
Lobster Batman, he's good. I would say for like Instagram, he's the most popular moment because he looks cool and it's funny. You can make lots of funny photos out of him, which is awesome.
And the lobster is awesome.
The lobster is a very, very cool piece.
The first lobster, isn't it?
Yeah.
For Lego.
Is it?
Yeah, it's the first ever.
I swear I'd seen them before.
I think
you mixed
it with the scorpion.
Yeah, it's like the crab as well. Scorpion crab.
Yeah, okay, cool. Second up is Kiss Batman.
Yeah. Also known as a Glambat.
Glambat, okay. That's pretty good, yeah.
Really cool. Really inspired by Kiss.
Yes.
That's really obvious.
Yeah.
But I also like the fact that we get the paper cape because this is the cheapest way to get it. Especially now when they've changed to like more fabric capes.
Yeah.
Very cool, very cool. This is the most popular one.
Oh?
Yep.
Ooh.
And not amongst adults, but amongst kids.
Oh.
I've stood here all yesterday, and I probably sold 15 of them.
Oh.
Wow.
Yeah. just literally kids are like, yep, 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 yep. I find it very strange. I would not have picked that myself. I never get this right. Every single minifigure series, I try and guess which one's going to be the most popular, and I never get it right. Very weird, very weird. So that's the first of like four bats.
Yeah, five.
So number three.
Number three is
Ballet Batman.
Which, yeah, Batman Ballet has the tutu and the fairy wing, so.
It's just fabulous.
Really cool.
Batman. Batman.
Yeah, one thing I've really thought about doing is a lot of people are making these like monochrome minifigures. You can now start doing that with Batman because we get the cowl in different colors.
You could do blue, you could do black, you could do brown.
Pink.
Oh, you could do monochrome. That's interesting.
Yeah.
That's an interesting, cool thing.
Yeah, we have dark blue, now we have brown, we have a lot of colors, so.
That's good.
Nice. I think he's probably my favorite.
Yeah.
Only because, I mean, it looks funny, it's Batman. You know? See, I quite like pink as a color as well, yeah. So I'm like, yeah, this is kind of cool.
Yeah, and this is something I really love about the whole Lego Batman movie. They are really making fun of Batman and the history of Batman. He's existed for like 76 years now, so.
That's quite a lot.
Yeah.
That same age as me. And then we have the fourth out of five Batman.
Clan of the Batcave.
What?
Or something like that.
Alright. This is Neanderbat.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've seen this one. I think I saw a cartoon with this one in. Where they went back in time and there's always a Batman in every time period.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought something like in the DC universe they have a lot of different timelines.
Yeah.
They have Earth 1, Earth 2, etc, etc. So I thought this was from like the dinosaur ages.
Yeah. Neanderthal.
Yeah.
I don't like him very much.
Yeah. Hit and miss.
Yeah. And there's six Batman. So this is number five now?
No, this is number four.
That's Catman. That's a villain, so... Yeah.
Really? I think out of the three of us, I know the least about Batman.
I don't know anything,
yeah.
I promise you.
But
you
said
as you can clearly see, I am a bit of a Batman fan.
Yes.
If it wasn't obvious. Yeah.
So number five, the last of the Batman, is Batman...
Vacation Batman.
My favorite.
Yeah.
It looks awesome.
So... Yeah, I'm not sure if that will show on the picture because he has the rubber ducky, but he has an awesome shirt on with a lot of Batman logos on.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah,
so,
like a kind of Hawaiian shirt, Batman style.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, fun. I think I had pajamas like that once. he's pretty cool. I mean, it's the rubber ducky, which is the piece that is going to excite everybody.
Yeah, and also... For people who don't know, we actually get a Bruce Wayne face with this one because he has the swing goggles.
What do you mean a Bruce Wayne face?
The other has the band for the white eyes.
Oh.
So this is the only figure you get the Bruce Wayne face with.
I see.
So it's the best one.
Cool. then number six is Barbara Gordon.
Yeah, Barbara Gordon.
Nice figure.
Yeah.
I was pleasantly surprised. I hadn't seen that she comes with the little Batman tile.
Yeah, it's a really cheap way to get it because you get it in some of the sets.
Okay, yeah.
But I'm curious what that actually is, because based from the trailers we can see that Barbara wants to team up with Batman.
I think that would be like a mini bat signal, no?
Yeah, mini bat signal or like a Batman badge that they work with Batman or something like that.
Could be. I'm annoyed that hat and hair is together.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. It would have been, you know, useful to have the hat without, but it's all right. I already had a few people asking yesterday, like, oh, do you know if the hat set the hair separate? Because they want to use the hat for other things. But that's okay.
Yeah, the hat exists in the same type of printing, but from different minifigures and stuff like that.
Number seven.
Where is he? There. We have Commissioner Gordon, which this is something a lot of DC fans have kind of bitched about.
Yeah.
Both Barbara Gordon and Commissioner Gordon, that they changed their ethnicity.
Did they? I saw it in the cartoons.
They are Caucasian in all of the...
In all of it?
Yeah, everything. There might be one or two, but not that well known, but mostly as... they are Convocation. So a lot of people have argued about that, but...
Oh, good God, it gives
yeah.
a fuck.
Yeah, I feel the exact same. So,
seriously?
Yeah, people the figure here. Looks cool.
Yeah,
so
it looks great.
That's all that counts, in my opinion.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he looks cool.
Yep. It's one of my favorites, actually. Just based on all of the detail on the printed double-molded arms and yeah, everything.
Back, the jacket, down
yeah, the
pants,
new hairpiece.
Pockets, face even.
Yeah.
That's nice. Number 8 is...
Prison Joker. Which... A lot of people dislike because we basically get the same figure in the Arkham Asylum set, but this one has a new face. But I actually like this one because we can get the Arkham jumpsuit in a very cheap way.
Mm. I mean, I'm assuming that, you know, the movie there's going to be lots of villains. It's not just going to be the Joker. But given that it is Batman, I expected the Joker figure to be quite... special, you know, for this kind of series, because it is the Joker.
Yeah, in one leaked picture, it showed that the Joker had, like, a chef outfit with a cooking hat and stuff like that. A lot of people wanted that figure, but...
That is so funny.
Yeah, and in one of the trailers, we can see him as a plane pilot, so...
Okay, cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't like the hair either. It seems they've done a couple of different versions of Joker hair now.
Yeah.
This one feels too big.
Yeah.
You know, it's
it
quite...
It does, yeah.
Yeah. It's like, boom, that's a lot of hair. What the hell is this?
That.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Robin.
Okay. Goggle boy. Yeah. Robin have weird glasses like
this. Yeah, they also changed the look of Dick Grayson, a.k.a. Robin. And that's not a spoiler for those who don't know, because he actually has Robins on his actual shirt. So.
Oh, right.
and his accessory is shark repellent spray from 1966, which I love that accessory.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Because if you have the 1966 Batcave, you can just throw that in as an accessory.
Mm-hmm.
Does he have a face?
No.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah,
that's
right. Yeah,
it's face.
Okay.
Yeah, no double sided.
Yeah, like under the goggles.
So, I don't know. I don't know if I like it. I don't like his eyes.
Yeah.
I find him a bit
it's
scary.
Interesting, at
it's
least.
Funny.
A bit scary. Okay, maybe just me. moving swiftly along, we have Barbara. Catgirl. Catgirl? Batgirl. Batwoman.
Pink Power Batgirl, I think.
Pink Power Batgirl.
It's either Pink Power Barbara or Pink Power Batgirl, I can't remember, but Pink Power something at least.
Pink Power something. Well,
oh! Oops.
The mess.
Christ.
So, really cool.
Yeah.
Also, monochrome for the Batarang.
Yeah.
So, we have a few colors of that now, which is cool.
I like the cape. It's so cool.
It's kind of a glossy cape, so that's really cool. It's a new hairpiece for Barbara Gordon, but it's also seen in some of the other sets. But this one has silver printing. The ones in the sets have gold.
Okay, alright, fair enough. Good. Next up is...
she also
faces.
Has a double-sided face. That's one of the few who has
very
a double-sided face.
Like the hair.
Red Hood, who has a double-sided face?
Not double-sided.
Okay, it's all the way around, see?
yeah, this is one of, also one of my favorites because Red Hood Joker is something that's really been missing. But one thing I'm curious about
is it Red Hood Joker? It's not. No.
This is Red Hood Joker, but the thing I'm curious about is this is Jason Todd Red Hood.
Yeah.
So
it's not Red Hood Joker. It's Jason Todd Red Hood.
I'm not sure what they are going for, but this look. Jason Todd has never had, but this head is Red Hood Jason Todd.
Hmm.
A lot of Red Hood there.
He's kind of cool.
Yeah,
he's
cool.
Next up is a Razor Man, a Razor Head.
Yeah.
He's cool.
The Eraser.
Seriously, they could have called him a Razor Head and they called him the Eraser.
Yeah. It was the 60s. What did you expect?
A Razor Head. Would have been awesome.
Yeah, really cool. A new double molded head.
Head-ish.
Yeah, something like that at least.
He's
yeah.
cool.
Yeah.
I like
his
suit.
Yeah.
Harley Quinn?
Yeah, Nurse Harley Quinn.
Nurse
so
Harley Quinn.
Nice new outfit for her.
The hair is crazy.
Yeah. Really like it actually.
Is there, in any other sets, does she have her hammer?
Not thus far. She has a bat,
okay,
ironically. Yeah.
Fair enough. Sharkman?
Orca. And she's actually a really cool figure, so...
I like the headpiece.
Yeah, it's just like a the headpiece who, or which has printed, so...
I'm picking this as the least popular.
Yeah, I can expect that.
I definitely will say in like 2 months' time, I'm going to have a crap load of sharks left around for sure. Yeah, least popular. Captain Fish?
Zodiac Master?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What the hell's he got fish for then?
It's a Zodiac sign.
DC.
If you think this is weird, yeah, in the movie we will actually see the very infamous Condiment King. Yeah. He shoots ketchup and mustard, so if you think this is far-fetched, you haven't seen anything.
Yeah.
Really I'm gonna leave the theater not knowing what I've just seen. Probably. I mean, pencil as a villain, like...
Doesn't work.
Yeah. I'm gonna use that figure for other stuff.
Yeah. The thing I can say is the silvery crab looks really cool.
That's true.
I haven't really gotten it in any other color than like yellow.
Yeah, it's orange, yellow, and red.
That's the only color. So getting it in silver is really cool. So
he could be my new king crab, actually.
Ooh. Yeah, and yeah, the fish we've got before, but the printing is overall cool. We have different zodiac signs all around.
On the sides.
Yeah.
And the sides.
Now I don't know the actual names of the zodiac signs, but yeah.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Yeah.
Then we have this is Batman.
This is Catman.
Who's a bad guy.
Yeah.
And what, he stole Batman's suit.
No, it's just very similar.
Yeah.
This is Thomas Blake.
Uh-huh.
Who was a criminal but has since changed his mind and is more of a like anti-hero now. And isn't really that popular.
I can see why.
Yeah, so the cool thing is also monochrome is we get the utility belt in brown.
That's the reason why I'm gonna get this belt.
And the Neo 52 cowl in brown.
The new 52.
Because this one doesn't have the chin strap.
I see.
It's based on the new 52 comic books.
Yeah, okay. I see. All the kids are calling him Wolverine, and they're very confused.
Coming from Marvel, same.
Yeah.
Since the claws were introduced with Wolverine, I can understand that.
Yeah, but it's interesting though, because I don't think Lego realizes that kids don't know. A 4-year-old doesn't know DC, Batman, Marvel. They just think, Batman. You know, why isn't Batman it? So this, literally, kids are going, I want the Wolverine.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, just so you know, it's not Wolverine. The parents are like, he doesn't care. And I'm like, he doesn't now. And he might get home and go, wait a second, this isn't Wolverine. Where's his, whatever. So, yeah, I don't know. It's interesting.
One thing also, it's the same color scheme as one of the variants of Wolverine.
Exactly.
So I think that's very funny. But also, to note off, there's a print flaw in the actual manual.
Oh, yeah.
The double molding shows that the legs are yellow and brown, so the boots are brown, but in the actual minifigure pamphlet, the boots are actually yellow. So, misprinting on all of the pamphlets.
Wow.
So, that's interesting.
You don't see that very often.
Yeah.
Then we have the Gun Buddy.
Yeah, which is March Harriet. It's a cool figure, but I dislike it because it's a henchman of the Mad Hatter, which is a bigger Batman villain, and we haven't got him yet. So that she doesn't really fit with anyone else.
Mm.
So that's a bit disappointing, but...
I dislike it because she's got a gun. Shouldn't have a gun.
Yeah.
Especially shouldn't have a Tommy gun. It's all... Not good. Space Bat? It was Space Bat, wasn't it? No, this is something else.
This is the calculator.
Why is he dressed as a spaceman if he's a calculator?
It's his suit. It's a calculator pad right there. Then we have the numbers. Hello.
That's my favorite trick.
It's just the detail. It's like Batman's bat. It doesn't do anything, but... Or, yeah, it kind of does, but I'm not here to...
Yeah.
Really cool, actually. That's the hello with numbers. If you turn it upside down.
I did that in primary school all the time.
I didn't write hello, I wrote boobs. You gotta write boobs. That's the best thing to write in a calculator. Hello.
Moving on. We have King Tut from the 1966 TV show.
Yep, I do remember watching King Tut.
Yeah.
It's good.
I have no idea what's going on.
Yeah, it's... As most of these figures, they are not that well known. It's one of the things I really like about the Batman movies, or the Lego Batman movie, is because they are giving awareness to all of the like deeper and really funny characters from Batman history.
Funny, deeper, cheaper.
Yeah.
Cheaper to license.
Yeah,
King Tut than it would be to license the Flash.
Superman, Flash.
Yeah, yeah. So. I'm sure, yeah. But I quite like him.
Yeah,
mostly because I like his staff, you think.
Yeah, that's cool. And that's cool. The first time we've gotten it since, like, series 2?
Yeah,
okay.
Ages ago.
Yeah,
it's been
so.
A long time.
Yeah.
And finally, we have Momo.
Yeah, Mime.
Mime. Is it Momo? She's got a Momo. What is Momo?
Yeah. Huh? I either like to call it Emperor's Apprentice.
Yep.
Or.
Punk
Joker or something.
Yeah, Star Wars.
Lightning.
Oh.
Every video has at least one Star Wars reference.
How close do we are at the end and we haven't said the word Star Wars yet? Oh. Yeah. Emperor's Apprentice. Okay, cool. I like the rubber Mohawk. I think that's fantastic.
Yeah.
I think it's very useful.
Yeah, and dark blue also.
Yeah.
So that's really
cool.
Except for that, nothing.
Nothing too special. I mean, I don't have a clue who it is, so I'm like,
Not,
I don't understand why somebody's called Mime, but they're shooting electricity out of their hands.
Have no clue what this character actually is.
Okay.
I know most of the other ones, but Mime, I have literally no idea.
Okay, cool. So that's all of them. I mean, they're pretty cool. I like them. I've got no problem with them.
Yeah.
Which is, that's my endorsement. Mr. Gill says, I've got no problem with them.
The quote in front of
me.
Yeah. It's the same thing he feels about us, so.
Yeah, I mean, they're good figures. I think they're going to be popular. I think, you know, I've probably said this before, I think 20 is, there's too many of them.
Yeah.
Most people will notice the price has gone up this
yeah.
year as well. I mean, you know, I'm sure some people are searching for the deals, but it's definitely gone up on the
yeah.
figures. I think that's a licensing thing, but I also
yeah.
think it's just generally this year price rises are happening.
Yeah, and especially in the UK, because the prices has really gone up on Lego overall, like 5% or something.
Oh. Yeah, but that's because some people voted for something stupid. I'm going to get so much hate if anybody sees that. So I think they're cool. I think they're going to be popular. I like them. I'm happy. You know? Next series is like May, so these are going to hang around for a long time. What the hell is that?
Yeah, that's the teaser for the next series.
That's like a swashbuckler.
Yeah. A lot of people are speculating based on the hat that it's something Pirates of Caribbean based or Disney Series 2 base, because a character from the Hunchback in Notre Dame has a similar type of hat and cape. So
I thought actually that they didn't have the Pirates of the Caribbean license anymore.
Yeah, they have like some sets planned for the fifth movie coming out year.
Okay.
So because they lost the license to Mega Bloks, then got it back, and a lot of different stuff happened to that. So
okay, so yeah. This series, it doesn't have a number because it is just a standalone series. But we will see. I'm pretty sure it's going to just be a normal collectible minifigure series come in May.
Yeah, we haven't gotten one in a while now.
Yeah.
So.
And then the next one I think is September, and that is definitely the Ninjago movie
probably.
Series. From what I can tell, these are cool. We'll probably do a little video about some of the sets. I get them next week, I think, or this week. But I'm going on holiday, so in a couple of weeks we'll have a talk about them and something like that. And that's all kind of good.
Yeah.
Talked a lot as usual. At the start I said we should keep this short. I don't think it's very short. Never is.
25 minutes.
25. That's too long. But we have to go. Please comment, suggest, like, whatever you do. 1 second, guys. And we will see you as soon as we can. Cheers. Thank you.